But we're gonna, because this song requires it. Those of you who've seen me before know I like to talk about the music I do. This has been a very important song for me. Dave Mason wrote it. I wish I would have. But he wrote it about a divorce, and I've never been divorced, so it wouldn't have made sense. But somebody took the song and did something else with it, and when Dave Mason heard Joe Cocker's version, he said, "That's not my song anymore." Well, we're here to give it back to David.
Thank you.
don't you get too lost in all I say. But at that time I really felt that way. But that was then, now it's today. I can't get off yet, so I guess I'm here. Song. Now I want to introduce you to my family. Now it's important, the blues is a family. We're all a big family. I've got so much family here, it's crazy. But I want you to meet this man, Jonah Telefona Nelson, my nephew. Alvin Evans, another nephew. I got my big nephew here, Joey Robinson. And I want to introduce y'all to my brother, Dexter Allen. We've been at it a long time. I came out with a couple albums this year, and one of them was my 11th. And so I decided, since it was my 11th album, I called it, I'm Just Getting Started. Moves in. just getting started with new lenses in my eyes. I had my lenses replaced. I don't have the near vision I used to. You know, what can I say? What can I say? Well, what can I do? What can I do? What can I say? Only want you more and more each day. There's a need I can't control. You reach all the way to my soul. I think I know how you feel. And I know that you know that it's real. I know what you can do. Know what you can't do. than I expected. But that's not going to matter on this song. This song is also the last one from that album, I'm Just Getting Started. This is a song I've sung for years. I first sang it with Brandon Santini. He played on the album on this song. I had my friend Taj Mahal's permission to do it, but we do it a bit different. And this is how we kind of do it in Memphis. Drunk, 'cause I'm the whiskey, but the blues made me laughing. Well, those who know me know that, first of all, what do you think of these guys? The good news is you get to hear them again. But you're going to hear some more of me first. Now, those who know me, I've got this slogan. People kept asking, what kind of blues do you play? I lived in Mississippi. You play Delta blues? Well, some. You know, but I play Chicago blues and Piedmont blues and whatever kind of blues I find. And so I came up with, rather than trying to say, they say, what kind of blues do you play? I say, all of it. That didn't seem to work. So I came up with this. I play free range blues. And I released two albums this year, actually two and a half, but two albums that I'm just getting started, and an acoustic album called, they call me Uncle Mick, because they do, and I figured I need to own it when Kingfish, Chris Stone, came up and said, Uncle Mick, how you doing? I've known him since he was eight, when he was just a little bitty guy. I love him, he's a great kid. Wonderful young man, and just honored to know him and so many other folks. But anyway, I did this album, they call me Uncle Mick. One of the reviewers said I let some young folks have a shot at it because I've got a couple guys playing harmonica on it, Watermelon Slim and Bobby Rush. And a guy by the name of Doug McLeod added a little guitar and a couple of tunes. And that's a lot of fun. But I'm gonna do the first song from it. When I first heard this song, I fell in love with it. That's important. This is a very old song. This was released in the year 65 BV. 65 BV, before Viagra. Well, listen here, folks, one thing's for sure. My old pencil won't write no more. Thank you. wrong. This woman's always away from home. Pharmaceuticals, you know. Thank you so much. This is a good day. It's a good day for the blues. I'd walk it in these shoes. If you can't be good, be good at it. Now, those who know me know I like to do things like what I call uncovers or bluesification. I like to find the blues that are hiding in a song. I did it with a guy named Mark Telesca, and I did a whole album of Beatles songs done as acoustic blues. We call it You Can't Do That. So I was in Daytona at the Blues Festival one time, and I happened to bump into a guy who's a drummer for a pretty important band out of Motown. Now, I grew up 100 miles from Motown in Michigan, and I heard this song. We were talking, and I said, oh my God, I could turn that into a blues song. So this is what we did. Sand. And I got town, brought to Memphis and Jackson. Now, some of you are aware of this. A couple of years ago, I lost my wife. We've been together 46 years and 3 days, and they were 30 of the best years of my life. But this song is the last song I sang to her that I knew she could understand. And when we recorded it, I had a young guy from Florida by the name of David Julia play on it with me. It's called Easy Doesn't Live Here. Anything I've seen, anything I've known before. wasn't easy getting where we are. Staying here ain't easy at all. That don't really matter. We get up every time we fall. If it wasn't easy, it wouldn't mean anything. Easy isn't how you spell true. The last song I sang to Molly that I knew that she could understand. I didn't have the band with me, but I want to clarify something. Molly died 2 years ago today, and I'll never not miss her. So she was in hospice for nearly a year, and I wrote this song anticipating what we knew was happening. So I'm going to try to finish with this song, and let's see if I can actually get through it. I couldn't when we recorded it. I think it was on my album, Wasted Youth. But let's see what we can do here.
But you know
standing here not speaking. Nodding through our tears. As we get closer to that moment, been coming on for years. We share the joys and sorrows.